Yes, good afternoon students. Again I am meeting you for the second chapter of this particular subject, amplitude modulation. So today in the morning and yesterday we made this discussion on principle of communication engineering. We have discussed basic concepts, told you about what is modulation, what is its need of modulation, what are the various frequency ranges of electromagnetic spectrum, and what are the different communication type. There are types of communication systems based on the nature of the signal, based on one way or two way directions, and based on whether it is as it is, I mean baseband transmission, or based on modulation. So besides, we have discussed the timing diagram of amplitude, frequency, and AM, FM, and PM. Fine. Now we will discuss what is amplitude modulation once again, how amplitude modulated signal can be expressed as in mathematical form, and how it can be shown graphically in time domain and as well as in frequency domain. So we will discuss all these things in this second chapter of principle of communication engineering. The topic is amplitude modulation. Fine. So as the name depicts itself, amplitude of what? Amplitude of carrier signal. So it will be varied in accordance with the instantaneous value of the amplitude of the modulating signal. Fine. So this is again a repetition of modulation. What is modulation? Modulation is the process by which some characteristics of carrier is varied in accordance with the modulating wave. This I told you number of times, and three characteristics of carrier are amplitude, frequency, and phase. So one of these characteristics will vary in proportion with the modulating signal, which is called as message or information signal. Fine. So as a result, modulation process is referred to as modulated signal, and all the information is contained in the varying characteristics of the carrier. I mean, if amplitude is being varied in accordance with the amplitude of the modulating signal, it means amplitude modulation and signal is transferred. And other two characteristics like frequency or phase will vary of the carrier itself. It means amplitude is transferred. Otherwise, but carrier itself, it is not containing any information. Rather, it is carrying the signal. Which signal? Baseband signal or modulating signal, which contains information. Fine. So now, under amplitude modulation, what are the different modulation system under amplitude modulation? I mean under analog modulation. Already told you, modulation systems, this can be amplitude or this can be angle. So in amplitude modulation, amplitude of the carrier is varied in accordance with the instantaneous value of the, or instantaneous magnitude of the modulating signal, which we are calling as information signal. It is further classified as, subdivided as, double sideband suppressed carrier. Now before that, double sideband full carrier as well. So that is common in case of AM. Then if we will suppress the carrier, only double sideband will come into the picture. So this is type. And if we will suppress the carrier as well as one sideband, then the modulation will be single sideband with suppressed carrier and with one sideband as well. So vestigial sideband, this is another type of amplitude modulation. Here one complete sideband and another some part, means vestige means some part of that signal that will be along with the carrier, it will be sent. So the term is vestigial sideband. And under angle modulation, frequency modulation, and phase modulation. But let us discuss first what is amplitude modulation under the chapter amplitude modulation. Fine. So principle of amplitude modulation, already told you that this is process of changing the amplitude of the high frequency carrier signal in proportion with the instantaneous value of the modulated signal, which is nothing but a baseband signal, or which is containing information signal. Now, already I have shown you in the last lecture how does an AM wave look like? Again, we can see this. Okay, look at first is baseband signal, which is containing information having low frequency and low power. EM is the amplitude of the modulated signal. Then the second one is the carrier, which will carry this. I mean, this is the high frequency and high power signal having amplitude EC, and the characteristics of this carrier will vary. Here it will vary as amplitude will vary. So wherever this amplitude is increasing or decreasing, accordingly the amplitude of the carrier is varying. And the third one is amplitude modulated signal. Wherever it is increasing, it means amplitude of the carrier is increased by the sum of, I mean by the amplitude of the modulated signal. Wherever it is decreasing, it is decreased by the amplitude of the modulated signal. This is called, this is amplitude modulated signal, and this is called AM envelope as well. Fine. And AM envelope. So once again, I have shown you how the amplitude modulated wave is looking like. Fine. Now we will see its mathematical expression, how the mathematical expression will look like. I mean, what are the various components in the double sideband suppressed carrier or double sideband full carrier is appearing. So what is the, we know that frequency of the sinusoidal carrier is much higher than that of the modulated signal. And in AM, the instantaneous value of the amplitude of the sinusoidal high frequency carrier is changed in proportion with the instantaneous amplitude of the modulated signal. This is the principle of AM. Already told you many times, means the amplitude of the carrier will vary in accordance with the amplitude of the modulated signal. Fine. And let me show you the time domain and display. I have already shown you in the previous slide like this. This is the time domain display of the amplitude modulated signal. Fine. Okay. Now, so note in this particular time domain, phase and frequency, these are the other two characteristics of the carrier. They will remain constant in AM. And major application is radio transmission and TV broadcasting, TV transmission as well. Fine. Look at modulated signal in practice may or may not be purely sinusoidal. But for your simplicity and for mathematical, not difficult expression we will get. So we are using majority of the time sinusoidal wave over here. So most of the times it will have a complex shape. Fine. AM envelope I have already shown you. Now what kind of mathematical expression of the AM wave? For this we will express a mathematical representation of AM wave in divide. It will be divided in two parts, namely first will in time domain, another will be a frequency domain description. Let us discuss first time domain description. I already told you for modulation, I mean if signal is being modulated, which signal has to be modulated? Carrier. With what it will be modulated? With the help of the modulated signal. This is 2.21 location is nothing, and this is a sinusoidal wave of modulated signal. See this small subscript M, EM, this is the instantaneous value of the amplitude of the modulated signal, and this value, capital EM, this value is amplitude of the maximum amplitude of the modulated signal, and omega M is equal to 2 pi FM, where FM is the frequency of the modulated signal. Fine. This is how the modulating signal, sinusoidal modulating signal, can be expressed mathematically as 2.2.1 as per this equation. And carrier will be expressed as mathematically like this. EC is equal to capital EC cos omega CT, where small EC is nothing. This is the amplitude of the instantaneous value of the carrier. Capital EC is the peak carrier amplitude. And of course, FC is the carrier frequency. Omega C is equal to 2 pi FC. Fine. And look, the see first one was the modulating signal. Third, second was the carrier signal. Now, amplitude modulated signal, how it can be expressed mathematically as. So this is 2.2.3 equation. AE subscript AM means amplitude, instantaneous value of the amplitude of the envelope, I mean modulated signal. It can be mathematically expressed as A cos 2 pi FCT. Fine. What is A? A is the amplitude of the carrier is increased by amplitude of the modulated signal. It can be subtracted also, but here we are, for your simplicity and easiness, we are taking the plus value. I mean, amplitude of the carrier is increased by the amplitude of the modulated signal. Fine. So both are added. This is A. And what is EM? EM is nothing. It is E, capital EM, cos 2 pi FMT. Fine. This is the sinusoidal mathematical expression of modulated signal. Now put the value of A over here. A. So we have put the value of A over here. Fine. Then you can take EC common. Here it will remain 1. It will be divided by EC. In the bracket term, this will turn, this term will come, and outside is cos 2 pi FCT. Fine. This EM over EC, it is nothing. This ratio is called modulation index, and it is represented as small m. Fine. So this is mathematically, this entire expression 2.25 is, this is, we are representing in time domain representation of AM signal. Okay. This, we have concluded one term, that is ratio of amplitude of the modulated signal to the ratio of the amplitude of the carrier signal. This ratio is nothing, it is a modulation index. This is also called modulation factor, or we can say sometimes we are calling it as depth of modulation. Fine. So this is the ratio of the amplitude of the modulated signal to the amplitude of the carrier signal. Now look at, if amplitude of the modulated signal, if this amplitude is less than this, fine, m will vary in between 0 and 1, and no distortion will be introduced in AM wave. But if E, the amplitude of the modulated signal, is greater than EC, I mean amplitude of the carrier, then of course m will be greater than 1, and result of the AM signal will be distorted. And this noise, this distortion is nothing, it is over distortion. I will show you in diagram. Fine. So modulation index is also called modulation factor. We are also calling it as modulation coefficient or degree of modulation. However, this modulation index is expressed as percentage. How it can be? You simply multiply this ratio with 100, you will get the percentage modulation. So m is a dimensionless quantity, but the value of the m in case of AM, it is varying between 0 and 1. 0 means 0% modulation. 1 means 100% modulation. If 0.5 is there, it means 50% modulation. If 0.75 is there, it, M value is 0.75, it means 75% signal is modulated. Fine. How we can express this in frequency domain? But before that, what is frequency spectrum and bandwidth of the AM wave? So expression or description will be in the, this is frequency domain. Fine. Here we are taking frequency spectrum along the, is a graph. Frequency spectrum of AM is nothing. It is a graph of amplitude versus frequency. Amplitude on y-axis and frequency on x-axis we will take. I will show you. Frequency spectrum of AM wave tells us about what, which frequency components are present in AM wave and what are their amplitudes. I will let you know. So again, we are considering the mathematical equation which we have just calculated. EAM is equal to EC plus EM cos omega MT. This is in bracket, and into cos omega CT outside. Fine. You simply take EC outside. Here it will remain 1. This EM will be divided by EC. Fine. And we know what is this ratio. This is M. Fine. Just now we calculated. This is M. Look. So we put the value of this ratio as M over here. So this is the 2.28 is the expression of amplitude modulated signal. Fine. And on simplifying it, you simply multiply this EC and cos omega CT with 1 as well as with the second expression. So we will get this term, look at 2.29, right? Now this expression, this first term is nothing, it is the amplitude of the carrier. But second term, M multiplied EC into cos omega MT into cos omega CT. Now this is, We know in mathematical expression this becomes the identity in trigonometry. Like you will remember, 2 cos A cos B is equal to nothing. Cos A plus B plus cos A minus B. So here one term will act as a cos A, another will act as a cos B. So there is a missing 2. So what we have to do? We have to multiply by the 2 and divided by the 2. Fine. So this way this can be solved. Look this way. So here, if you are multiplying 2.29, the second term with second term of this expression, you are multiplying with 2 and divided by 2. So it will become 2 cos A cos B. I mean cos omega CT and cos omega MT multiplied by 2. 2 will come forward over here. So this will be reduced as MEC. Of course, it will be divided by 2 also. So MEC will be divided by 2. First cos A plus B, like cos omega C plus cos omega M, cos omega C plus M omega M into T, like this. And another term is, of course, MEC by 2, because here this is common, not divided by 2. So 2 will come over here. It will be mathematically expressed like this. So it will be multiplied by MEC by 2. Both the term will be multiplied by MEC by 2. Look at first term will plus, another will be in this form. I mean omega C minus omega MT. So these are the 3 terms we are getting from this. Fine. Now put the value of using this identity, how 2.29 can be expressed as in 2.210. Fine. The first term is, of course, it is carrier, and second term, see, this is a plus sign, it is upper side band. And this third term is nothing, it is containing negative sign, but of course amplitude of this band is MEC by 2, and amplitude of upper side band is also MEC by 2. And this is the frequency component of upper side band, and this is the frequency component of lower side band, and of course omega C the frequency of the carrier. Amplitude of carrier is EC. Here amplitude of the side band is MEC by 2. Amplitude of upper side and amplitude of the lower side band is MEC by 2. Now how all these 3 components can be expressed graphically? Let me tell you how. Look at, so as I already told you, frequency domain is nothing. This is a graphical representation between amplitude along y-axis and frequency along x-axis. Look at carrier. We are showing here positive value of the frequency only. Carrier, of course, it is having high frequency and high amplitude, of course. So if the amplitude of the carrier is EC, upper side band, it will come on the right side of this. Of course, this frequency of this, the frequency of this will be added in FC. So this will come as FC plus FM. But amplitude is what? It is MEC by 2. And what about the amplitude of the lower side band? It is MEC by 2. Fine. But frequency component is FC minus FM. And if we want to calculate the bandwidth of this amplitude modulated signal, look at upper minus lower. You subtract lower frequency component from the upper one. So you will get 2 FM because FC will be cancelled over here. Fine. So it means 2 FM is the bandwidth of the amplitude modulated signal. Fine. So right now, this is, I hope you understand the concept of frequency domain as well, and its mathematical expression as well. So look at how we can calculate the bandwidth of the, see, bandwidth of upper side band minus bandwidth of lower side band. I mean frequency of upper side minus frequency of the lower side band. Upper minus lower. So look at, you put the value of upper side band minus put the value of lower side band. So this minus will change the sign. Here FC will be cancelled with FC. FM plus FM. Sign will be changed. So it will come 2 FM. So bandwidth of the AM system will be 2 FM. I mean twice the frequency of the modulating signal. Fine. So go through this mathematical example. This is a solid example. Here, let us see quickly at a glance. See, modulated signal in this example, a modulated signal is 10 sine 2 pi into 10 to the power 3 t. Look at sine 2 pi, this is f. 10 to the power 3 means f, means 1k. So look at this 1 kilohertz fm. Because it is a modulated signal, frequency will be frequency of the modulated signal. is used to modulate a carrier. Now this frequency component, I mean this modulating signal will modulate this. This is a carrier signal, 20 sine. Look at the amplitude, it is increased. And frequency is 10 to the power 4. This is also increased. This is 1K, this is 10K. Fine, now? This is 10 kilohertz. Fine, look at. And amplitude is 20 volt. Fine. And amplitude of the modulating signal is 10 volt. Look. So mathematically, modulating signal will be expressed as this. You simply compare the values and put down over here. In similarly, in case of carrier signal, right? What he wants to achieve, he said, find the modulation index, percentage modulation, frequency of the sideband components and their amplitude, and what is the bandwidth of the modulated signal. Also draw the spectrum of the AM wave. Now this mathematical problem, I mean, it is looking difficult, but when you will solve it and compare with the amplitude modulating signal, mathematical expression as well as carrier signal, it will become easy for you. Fine. So we have from this EM is 10 volt, amplitude of the modulated signal, frequency of the modulated signal is 10 to the power 3 hertz means 1K. Similarly, amplitude of the carrier signal is 20 volt and frequency of the carrier signal is 10K. Fine. How to calculate percentage modulation of modulation index? See, M is like this. So 0.05, if you want to calculate it, if you want to calculate a percentage modulation, multiply this with 100. So it will come 50%. So 0.05 is 50% modulation. Fine, now? Similarly, frequencies of upper sideband is nothing. You simply add the frequency of the modulated signal in carrier. So what is the carrier frequency? 10K, and this is 1K. It will become 11K, 11 kilohertz. That is the frequency of the upper sideband. And subtract, carrier will be subtracted by frequency of the modulated signal, lower sideband. So you will get 9K. Fine, now? And what is the amplitude of the sideband? We know this is MEC by 2. Put the value of M, that is 0.5. EC is 20. And divided by 2, this will come 5 volt. So this is amplitude of the each sideband. And what is bandwidth? We have just calculated. This is 2 FM. So 2 times 1K. This is 2K. Now, how the spectrum of the AM will be looking like in frequency domain? Look at free. This is the frequency of the carrier, 10K, and this is the amplitude of the carrier. See, amplitude of the upper sideband with the magnitude 5 volt, but frequency is 11K. And amplitude of the lower band, of course, look at amplitude of the lower sideband and upper sideband is same, but frequency of the upper and lower is different. Fine. So I hope you understand the concept of spectrum of AM wave and completely understand the mathematical problem by using the expression of amplitude modulated signal. I mean, what is mathematical, how mathematically expressed modulated signal and carrier signal as. Another example you can go through at your own, this is solved over here. What is linear modulation and over modulation? So in the beginning of this lecture, I expressed that if M is greater than 1, I mean, if it is more than 100% modulation, so over modulation will result, it will come into the picture. But what is linear modulation? If M is varying between 0 and 1, not greater than 1, so this, the term will be linear modulation. See, M is less than equal to 1. If the percentage is modulation is less than 100, then this type of modulation is called linear amplitude modulation. Amplitude modulation term, this amplitude modulation is associated with the term linear, means M is less than equal to 1 or modulation is less than 100. But I will show you. So if M is greater than 1, then over modulation will come into the picture. It means percentage modulation greater than 100. Now how all this is looking like this? Look at this diagram. See, look at these three diagrams. Fine. See here, look at, now this is this modulated signal. Of course, this is amplitude modulated signal. Now this part is not touching this line. I mean, so it means M is less than 100. So less than modulation index or percentage modulation is less than 100. Now it is touching this. Look at amplitude of the carrier and amplitude of the modulated signal. This is same. Here, amplitude of the modulated signal is less than the amplitude of the carrier signal. So that is why it is less than 100% modulation. Here it is because EM is equal to EC, and now EC will come over here. It one will remain over here. It means 100% modulation. And look at the graphical representation. But if look at here, EM is greater than EC. So look at amplitude of the modulated signal is greater than the amplitude of the carrier. So it is over modulation. M is more than 100%. Look at now. This is coming down, and this is coming up. Here, this part is showing distortion. So this distortion is due to overmodulation. As M is greater than 1, means there is more than 100% modulation. So this will not be accepted. So either this can be accepted, fine, upper one, A part, where modulation is less than 100%, or maybe 100%. But if it is more than 100%, this will not be accepted. Rather, it will show a distortion, and the performance of the A amplitude modulated signal will be deteriorated, or it will be degraded. Fine. Now, if M is zero, it means the value of the modulated signal is entirely absent. So carrier will remain as it is. Carrier will remain as it is. Nothing and no, its amplitude of the carrier will remain as it is, as M is zero. So I hope you understand the concepts of modulation. What is linear modulation with by keeping the value of M is equal to zero. M is between 0 and 1, then it is equal to 1, and it is more than 1 in case of overmodulation. Fine. So we have compared the four diagrams by taking the value of the M. M is nothing. It is modulation index. It is varying between 0 and 1. Now, how we can calculate the modulation index? How we can calculate the modulation index? Now, we have to, for that, we have to, this kind of amplitude modulated signal is displayed on the screen of the CRO. Fine. It is appearing like this. Now look, this is the amplitude of the carrier, and this is the amplitude of the modulated signal. Now it is increased over here, but decreased over here. Fine. Now this is the maximum value, and this is the minimum value. Fine. Now, minimum value of the amplitude modulated signal, and minimum value of the maximum amplitude value. Modulated of the signal. This is the amplitude of the modulated signal. Of course, the amplitude of the carrier. Now, fine. So this is how it can shown in time domain graph. Now, from there here, we can calculate the value of M. We also already know that what is modulation index M? M is nothing. It is EM by EC. Fine. So now here, but here we have to express EM in terms of E maximum and E minimum. Somewhere it is maximum, somewhere it is minimum. EC, EM and EC in terms of E maximum and E minimum. Fine. Now, so look at EM is nothing. If you will calculate EM from this graph, fine, EM from this graph, simply it will come E maximum minus E minimum over 2, or simply you put multiplied 2 by EM. Now this is 2 times EM. This is 2 times EM. Fine. Now this EM and this EM. Now what is the remaining? E maximum minus E minimum. Fine. Now, so it is equal to 2 EM, and 2 will come over here. This is, we have calculated the value of EM. Now what about carrier? You simply calculate the value of EC from this time domain graph. EC. Now EC is what? Subtract the value of this value EM from E maximum. So this will come EC. Look at, fine. So EM and EC we have calculated. You simply put the value over here. EC. EC is nothing. This is E maximum minus EM. Now put the value of EM over here. Solve it. So this will come like this. Fine. Now, this will come like this. Right? E maximum minus E maximum by 2 plus E minimum 2. Now this is 1 E maximum, this is half E maximum. So 1 minus half means half, right? So your EC will come, look at, EC will come E maximum plus E minimum by 2. Fine? From this you can calculate. What we know, M is equal to EM by EC, right? So you can simply put down the value of E. Now put down the value of EM in terms of this, and EC we have calculated. So ratio 2 will be cancelled with 2. The remaining expression is E maximum minus E minimum over E maximum plus E minimum. So this is how we can calculate M in terms of E maximum and E minimum. Modulation index from the time domain graph of where somewhere it is showing maximum value, somewhere it is showing minimum value. Fine, the amplitude of the modulated signal. So we have calculated the value of the M. Fine. Now we can skip this calculation of modulation that you use. And this is a trapezoidal display with the help of CRO. Okay, we can skip this. Fine. So these are some solid examples. I hope you enjoyed the lecture. This is enough for today. We have discussed about amplitude modulation method once again in time domain and frequency domain, and calculated the mathematical expression of amplitude modulated signal as well. And the terms, three frequency components, carrier, upper sideband and lower sideband. And we have solved some numerical problems as well. And what is linear modulation, over modulation? Fine, this we have calculated. I hope you understand the concepts. You might have enjoyed the lecture. Fine, once again under Mission Fateh, keep a social distance, avoid social gathering. Fine, use mask on your face so that you may not be affected by the corona positive patient. Safe yourself, keep safe yourself, stay at home, stay healthy, fine, and download the COVA. Good luck, thank you, all the best, have a good day. Thank you.